does it really make sense that there'd only be about 7 natural wonders in the world? Not really, especially when you think of the scope of the Earth. There's lots of stunning things to see on our planet. Let's take a look at some you might not have even heard of. 22. The Amazon. Whether it be the rainforest or the river, there's lots to be found in the Amazon. While most of the forest can be found in the territory of Brazil, it also spans to Guyana, Peru, Colombia, and more. The rainforest, or jungle, has been around for about 55 million years, forming during the Eocene era. When it comes to the river, it counts as the largest river in the world, according to discharge volume of water. The biodiversity of the Amazon is also legendary, with new species being found in the landscape all the time. 21. Grand Canyon. Spanning a length of 277 miles or 446 kilometers at an elevation of 2,600 feet or 800 meters, the Grand Canyon proves to be an enormous force to be reckoned with. This steep-sided canyon has an age of about 5 to 6 million years, the Colorado River cutting through it to form the depth and structure it appears as now. Native Americans made the Grand Canyon their home for thousands of years, with the first Europeans not arriving to the site until 1540. The Pueblo people hold the rocky formation as sacred land. 20. Iguazu Falls. Located between Brazil and Argentina, the Iguazu Falls stand at a height of 269 feet or 82 meters at the tallest. The water drops at over 275 feet down, with the falls more on the Argentinian side, while the river flows through Brazil. Legend has it that when a deity wanted to marry a beautiful woman, she scorned the god and fled with her mortal partner. As a result, the god created the waterfalls and condemned the pair to eternally falling. 19. Table Mountain. From Cape Town's beach sides, you can make out the shape of Table Mountain in the distance. One of the most famous characteristics of the mountain includes its plateau, which measures at about 2 miles or 3 kilometers wide. It measures to a height of 3,461 feet or 1,055 meters. Sometimes, you can even see clouds covering right over the plateau. Making what's called a tablecloth image. 18. Azerbaijan Mud Volcano. You're probably used to seeing what regular volcanoes look like, all that molten lava spilling down the mountainside, whether it be in pictures or real life. When it comes to mud volcanoes, however, you've got to admit that sight is a little more rare, even though there's supposedly about 400 mud volcanoes in the entire world. Since 1810, a recorded 200 eruptions have taken place at the 50 volcanoes in Azerbaijan. With some even located under the water of the Caspian Sea. 17. The Dead Sea. People famously sit and float in the Dead Sea, much easier than you could in any other body of water. The Dead Sea, located between Jordan, Israel, and Palestine, has a density of 1.24 kilograms per liter, which means trying to swim through it looks more like just floating. It is the deepest hypersaline lake in the entire world, with a depth at about 997 feet or 304 meters. When compared to the ocean, the Dead Sea is about 9.6 times as salty. 16. Milford Sound. It is considered the most famous tourist destination in all of New Zealand, and at one point was called the 8th wonder of the world. In Maori, Milford Sound is called Pio Pio Tahi, which comes from the sound a Pio Pio bird makes. This fjord can be found on the southwest region of South Island, part of the Fjordland National Park. You'll see different peaks here, including the Elephant, which reaches 4,977 feet or 1,517 meters tall. 15. The Great Barrier Reef. Due to warming ocean temperatures, coral bleaching in turn has the Great Barrier Reef receding. Even still, it counts as the largest coral reef system in the world. It comprises of over 2,900 reefs, which spans for over 1,400 miles or 2,300 kilometers. The reef system sits off the east coast of Queensland, Australia, and can even be seen from space. 14. Uluru. Also found in Australia is Ayers Rock, also known as Uluru. Located in Australia's Northern Territory, Uluru was named by the Aboriginal people. This sandstone formation stands out on the mostly flat land of Central Australia. It stands at a height of 1,142 feet, or 348 meters high, and a circumference of 5.8 miles, or 9.4 kilometers. It is categorized as an inselberg, a hill that rises and is surrounded by flat lowlands in a dry region. 13. Cliffs of Moher. Now those are cliffs people sing about in old songs. Just look at them. They are definitely majestic. Do we call things majestic anymore? Anyways, here are the famous cliffs of Moher, carved into the southwestern side of Ireland. Not only is just staring at the cliffs a nice view, but if you get to the top, you'll be able to see the 12 pins, the Mount Turks, and Galway Bay. They stand at an elevation of 509 feet or 155 meters and go on for about 14 kilometers. 12. The Matterhorn. Not the ride in Disneyland, but that is the inspiration. The highest point of the Matterhorn goes up to 14,692 feet or 4,478 meters high and looks kind of like a wizard hat. You can't see it from this photo, but glaciers surround this mountain in the Alps. While in German it's referred to as the Matterhorn, the French call it the Cervin, while the Italians refer to it as the Cervino. In Europe, it counts as one of the highest summits, found between Italy and Switzerland. 11. Angel Falls. Named after United States aviator Jimmy Angel, who was the first pilot to fly over the falls, Angel Falls has a lot of its fame to its name thanks to its height. It reaches about 3,211 feet upwards, or 979 meters, with a plunge of 2,368, or 807 meters, making it the highest uninterrupted waterfall in the whole world. 10. Perito Moreno Glacier. Unlike all the other huge glaciers in the world, Perito Moreno is actually getting bigger instead of retreating. It measures to a length of 19 miles or 30 kilometers, and an area of 97 square miles or 250 kilometers squared. This glacier sits in the Los Glaciares National Park in Argentina, and serves as a popular tourist destination in the country's famous Patagonia. The ice field here ranks as the third largest reserve of fresh water on Earth. 9. The Norwegian Fjords. Norway is known for a lot of things, for the safe environment, the lush landscapes and the even big cities, and of course, the fjords. Ask anyone who's visited this Scandinavian country. They'll say one of the most breathtaking sights are the Norwegian fjords. There's a handful to be found here, all different sizes and even with their own unique characteristics. What's the same, however, are the crystalline waters and lush mountainsides. 8. Valle da Lua. It looks like wet clay, but that's straight up rock that's been eroded by sand and water. It almost looks alien the way the elements have shaped this landscape near the Rio São Miguel in Brazil. The Valle da Lua turned out the way it did after eons of sand and water hollowed out the rock. If you want to visit it, the place is still open to visitors despite being located on private property. The rocks here used to be lava flows, the petrified shapes making it perfect for natural water slides to occur. 7. The Sahara Desert. Besides the Arctic and Antarctic, the Sahara Desert counts as one of the biggest deserts on Earth. For some reference, it's about the size of the entire area of China. And for the record, it does count as the largest low-latitude hot desert. The Sahara can be found in North Africa, taking up about 31% of the continent. It looks like what most people picture in their minds. The Sahara consists of just an expanse of sand dunes covering lands. 6. The Black Forest. The largest forested mountain range in southwest Germany is the famous Black Forest. There's even ham and cake named after this place. The entire area measures to 2,320.2 square miles or 6,009.2 kilometers squared. The entire area measures to 2,320.2 square miles or 6,009.2 kilometers squared and meets the Rhine Valley to its south and west. This German landscape includes many rivers and lakes, including the more well-known Danube. 5. The Galapagos Islands. Charles Darwin came all the way from England to the Galapagos Islands in South America to observe the immense diversity of wildlife here, and to this day, it continues to induce wonder. The islands belong to the administration of Ecuador and is made up of volcanic islands that form an archipelago. 4. Lenzuas Marañenses. At the National Park of Lenzuas Marañenses, you'll come across sandy landscapes that look like they came from a movie or painting. Located in northeastern Brazil sits the terrain of aquamarine blue and white sand. The sand dunes might make it look like a desert, but it actually gets subject to a lot of rain. It is, after all, located right beside the Amazon forest. 3. Mount Everest. It is the tallest mountain in the world above sea level, and one that many people try to traverse every day in order to say they've conquered the beast that is Mount Everest. It reaches an elevation of 29,029 feet or 8,848 meters, part of the cold region of the Himalayas, which is home to many other tall mountains such as Kanchenjunga and Dalagiri. 2. The Great Blue Hole. It looks like a huge ink blot in the sea, and it's one of the most visited scuba diving attractions ever. The Great Blue Hole can be found near Lighthouse Reef, both part of the Belize Barrier Reef Reserve System. The submarine sinkhole sits just 43 miles or 70 kilometers away from Belize City and has a circumference of 1,043 feet or 318 meters. In comparison to other reef dives you might experience, the one down Great Blue Hole seems to be a dark one and not as colorful as you're probably used to as a scuba diver. 1. Aurora Borealis. There's nothing cooler than seeing an aurora in the sky. It's just surreal. It's just a surreal sight, isn't it? It doesn't make sense that you'd see all the colorful lights in the sky and that it'd be a natural sight. But it is. One of the more well-known instances are the Northern Lights, or the Aurora Borealis, seen in the skies over the Arctic. The lights show up as any other color, though they mostly appear in emerald green. If you do get the chance to visit some of the coldest regions in the world, don't miss out on looking up into the night sky. Which of these places do you think you'd visit? Do you think we left out a favorite of yours? Let us know by commenting down below. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Talk to you guys later.